Hello everyone, my name is Ian and welcome to today's video. Today I'm going to show you how to use a Twitter-like feature inside of your application, inside of your iOS application, to limit the number of characters inside of a text view. So what you're going to get is pretty much what you see on the screen, and you can also see this in the little box, or the smaller video on the screen as well, in the actual Twitter application. So you can see here in my computer screen in the iOS simulator, you can see that there's a text view here. You just can't really see it because there's no border on it, but there is a text view there. And as you can see, the cursor is there, the insertion point here. And there is a little label down here that says 140 and a button that says tweet, right? So now when we type in hello, as you can see right down below, it adjusts to however many characters we have. So how are you? And we can click tweet, and we're gonna get this alert view that says tweet has been posted. And once we get, we're just gonna type in some mumbo jumbo here. So this mumbo jumbo, and as you can see, once we go from 21 to 20, we get orange, so that means we're kind of warning. And then now we're going to come down here, and then once we get to 10, it turns to red. And Gamecocks suck, because they do. It goes to negative 7, and let's try and tweet it. And it says there's too many words in this tweet, so we need to delete some, and let's go all the way back to negative 1. Still can't do it, because there are too many. So let's go back to minus y. We're just going to delete one character, hit tweet, and the tweet has been posted because there are zero characters left, and that's still enough to tweet. And of course, go to one, and it works the same way. So let's go ahead and jump into Xcode, and let's see how to do this. Alright, so now that we're on our computer, we're going to go ahead and create a single view application, but of course, you can implement this into your own application. And we're going to just name this, text view limit. And click next and create. And this is going to be on GitHub. All the project files will be on GitHub, presuming I can actually get them on there. So first what we're going to do is close this a little bit, and we're gonna go into our viewcontroller.swift, and we're gonna go ahead in here, we're gonna do comma after UI view controller, and we're gonna do UI text view delegate. Alright, so now that we're done with that, let's go ahead and hop into our main.storyboard. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to set this to iPhone 6 just because it looks a little bit better. And I already have the iPhone 6S open, so that way we don't have to worry about constraints, as we do not have a whole lot of time. So what we're going to do is we're going to add a text view. So just simply search text view. And we're going to set the text to placeholder. Alright, and we're going to make this the full access as placeholder, and we'll just put this in right there. Alright, now we're going to add a label. We'll give it some room, and now we're going to add a button. And of course, this is terrible user interface design because it looks absolutely terrible, but that's okay. And we're just going to call this tweet, and we're going to set this to white, and we're going to come down here and we're going to set this to blue, and let's go ahead and we're going to make this a little bit bigger so it kind of looks like Twitter, not really. So this is just what we're doing. And then right here, we're going to click and drag from here to our view controller right here, and we're going to put delegate. So this way, our text view is accessing the UI text view delegate. So now let's go ahead, I'm going to close this just a little bit. Close this just a little bit, and let's go ahead and open up the assistant editor. I'm going to close this because we're done with it. And we're going to go ahead and add some outlets. So this is going to be our tweet text view. Alright, so this is going to be our chars left, label, and this button right here. Let's click and drag, and this is just going to be tweet button. That will be an outlet, and down here we're going to go ahead and create an action as well. So we're going to do tweet. Alright, so add this as an action and touch up inside, and we're done here, and we can go ahead and close the assistant editor, as I do not believe we need the view controller or the storyboard anymore. So the reason why we do is UI text view delicate is so that we can access more functions that kind of make it more not necessarily designable, but we can just give more functionality to the text views. So what we're going to do is we're going to come over here and we're going to create a function first, and we're just going to do we're just say check remain chars, and we do that parentheses, and there we go. So now we have a function, and down here we're going to do text view. And as you can see, these are all the methods or the functions that we get with importing the text view delegate, and if we were to delete them, we don't get them anymore, so that's the reason why we want to keep that there. So we're going to do text view, and we're going to do text view did change, and now we're going to do func text view did begin editing. And what is this saying? Alright, nope. Alright. So now we're going to come right up here, and we're going to go ahead and we're going to add some of the math functions. This is where pretty much all of the math is going to take place. So we're going to say let allow chars, and we're going to have this equal to 140. And now we're going to do let chars in text view. We're going to have this equal to negative, so it's going to be negative description, not description, why do I keep saying that? Negative to tweet text view dot text dot characters dot count. So what this is doing is it's going to take all of the text in our text view, or all the characters in our text view, and just return an integer, or give us an integer. And now we're going to do let remaining chars equal to allowed chars plus chars and text view. So that's all the math that we need pretty much for right now. All right. And so what we're going to do here is we're going to do print, just to check to see if this is working. We're going to do remaining chars. And then for text view did change, we're going to, we're going to call our function. So we're going to check remaining chars. And we're just going to hit Command R, and this is going to run. And I'll be back once it's compiled and is starting to run. Alright, so here we are. It has loaded. And let's go back here, and we're just going to view the console. So I'm going to make that a little bit bigger. And we don't need this other side. So when we first click, our keyboard should show up. Let's see, why is that not working? Here we go. And let's see, don't know what that means. Okay, so now once we click off, let's delete that, we should get a number, so 140. So now let's type hello, and that's four words, so 140 minus 4, we should get 135. And I can't really switch between views really, but every time you type, as you can see, it will actually automatically run the numbers, so, or print the number left. So it works, we're good. We're just gonna clear the console. We're just gonna make this a little bit smaller. And now we're gonna go ahead and get into making the, showing the number in our label and making it change color once we reach a certain, certain number. So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna come up here to our check remaining charge, and we're going to go ahead and delete the print statement because we know it works, so we don't need to do it again. So, and let's go ahead and we're going to implement the we're going to implement it to where it shows in our label right here. And first what we're going to need to do is we're going to go up to our view did load, and we're going to go ahead and set the text. So we're going to chars left label dot text. I want to go ahead and set this equal to 140, so that way when we run, it won't say label, it will already say 140. As you can see, it says 140 right now. So now we're done with our view did load. We don't really need it anymore. So now what we're going to do is we're going to do remaining. We're going to come down here to our check remaining chars. So we're going to do remaining. Chars left. I get confused. Chars left label dot text, and it's late, so you know I'm just tired. So remaining chars left dot, or chars left dot text is equal, and we're going to go ahead and we're going to say string, and we're going to do remaining chars. So now let's go ahead and we're going to run this, and let's see if it does it. And let's let this load, and here we go. So let's click on here, delete placeholder, and as you can see, it updates. So we have 140 left. Hello, my name is Thompson, and I am currently in my room talking to my computer. All right. So it says 56. Okay, so that's 56 characters. And let's go ahead and we're just gonna type in some random stuff. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna implement, next we're going to implement the color changing. So it will change the colors. Once it gets to 20, it will change the color. Once it gets to 10, it will change the color again. And then once it gets below zero, we're going to click this, and we're either going to get an alert view that says we can post the tweet or we cannot post the tweet, depending on how many characters are left. So we're going to come back in here and we're going to make some room. So we're going to do if remaining chars is less than allowed chars, then we're going to do remaining chars. Chars left label dot text color. Color equals UI color dot black color. This is just going to be our normal color. It should be less than or equal to. Alright, so now we're going to come down here and then we're going to do if remaining chars is less than or equal to 20. Then we're going to do chars left label dot text color is equal to UI color dot orange color. So this can kind of be a warning. And then we're going to come down here again and we're going to do if remaining chars is less than or equal to 10. Then we're going to do our chars dot text color is equal to UI color dot red color. And let's go ahead and hit Command R to run it again, and once it's compiled we should see that it starts to change colors. Okay, so now we're going to do hello, my name is Ian Thompson, and I am so cool. And now we're just going to just click some random stuff and get us to 30 right here. Okay, so now we're at 21, and now when we hit 20, so we go back, hit 20, and there we go, it's turned to orange, so it's giving us a warning, we're almost going to run out. Let's go down to 11. Once we hit 10, turns to red, and then once we do that, then it's at 0. Alright, so now we're going to implement, when we click the button, it will give us an alert view saying we can post it or we cannot post it. So we're going to come up here to our view did load, I believe so. Now we're going to come down here to our, we're going to come down here to our tweet button, and we're going to do if. Well, actually, what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and copy this right here. We're just going to do, paste it. Okay, so now that we've copied and pasted that, we're going to simply just do if remaining chars dot, is less than or equal to 0. Or actually, what we're going to do is less than 0, because if it's less than or equal to, then it's not going to let us post it if it's equal to it. And if there are 150 characters or 140 characters, then of course we want to let them, but once it gets to -1, then we don't want to let them. So we're just going to have it set to less than. Alright, so now we're going to do let alert equal UI alert control. Sorry if you hear a siren in the background. And we're going to do title, and we're just going to do too many words in tweet. And our message is going to be nil, as the title pretty much says it all. And our preferred style is just going, dot alert. Alright, now we're going to do alert dot add action. Now we're going to do UI alert action. It's going to be this. The title will be okay. The style will be dot default. And our handler will be nil, as we do not need a completion handler for that. And now we're just gonna go ahead and hit enter. And now we're going to do alert. We're gonna do self.present view controller. We're gonna do alert. And now we're going to do animated true. And our completion will be nil, as we do not need a completion handler. Else, we're going to just copy and paste this to save time. And we're just going to change this to tweet has posted. All right, so now we're going to hit Command R, and we're going to see if this all works, and it should. And also, one bug I did find the last time we did it is it says 140 right here, but our placeholder, it does take up text, so we don't. That's not necessarily true. So whatever you're going to have inside the text view, you just want to go ahead and counter that in as when you set up here for in the view did load as the preset text. So as you can see, once we start editing, it will automatically drop down to 130. So let's go ahead and we're just going to type some stuff. Clemson will win the national championship. Go Tigers. All right, so Tigers are my favorite team. And right here, we don't have anything to get rid of the keyboard. We can just do Command K to get rid of it. So now we're just gonna hit tweet. And tweet has been posted, yay. Alright, so now let's go ahead and hit Command-K again to bring back the keyboard. And now we're just going to tweet a whole bunch of mumbo-jumbo. Hold on, let's go back to 20. Alright, so can we tweet it? We can tweet it. Alright. So now let's go to 10. Can we tweet it? We can tweet it. All right. Let's go down to 1. Can we tweet it? Tweet has been posted. All right. And now at 0, let's see if we can tweet it. Tweet has been posted. All right. At 0. Now let's go to negative 2. Too many words in tweet. All right. That is it, everyone. All right. Thank you for watching. If you have any questions, comments, concerns, complaints, remarks, statements, any of that, leave those down in the comments below, and I'll get back to you as soon as I can with 16 subscribers who don't even watch my videos. Should be easy. Alright, so if you enjoyed this video, please like it, and if you want to share it, share it. I don't care if you want to, you know, put it on like Reddit or something, which I'll probably do right after I post this. Just go ahead and do that. If you want to upvote it, you can. And if you want to follow me on Instagram or Twitter, you can, of course, look at that down in the description below. And you can always look at these GitHub files if I get them up there. I've only successfully put one thing on GitHub, and I don't know if I'm going to be able to do it for this one. So that will be a big thing if I can. So anyway, everyone, thank you for watching. If you have any questions, comments, concerns, remarks, statements, any of that, leave those down in the comments below, like I said. And thank you for watching, and the date is December 29th, so everyone have a great new year, and let's hope 2016 can be a great year to my 16 subscribers. Thank you everyone for watching. My name is Ian, and I'll see you in the next one.